I'm afraid. I'm afraid to open my mouth and say to somebody what I'm really feeling. And I'm not talking about petty little things, okay? I'm talking about deep stuff. All right?
Yes.
I'm not talking about petty, I'm talking about deep stuff. Amen? You'd be surprised what happens when people get money.
Yes.
Surprised.
Surprised.
Become like their God or something. You know, anyhow. Blah, blah, blah. That's all I can say. But, you see, it does not matter, does it?
That's right.
Say, Denise, it does not matter.
Denise, it does not matter.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And thank you again. I'm okay, Pastor? Then we see the violence enter into the picture through the verbal attack, the actions or acts physically, emotionally, sexually. The final piece of the armor is murder. This may be through words, actions, or deeds. I hate you. Oh, I love them, but I just don't want to hang out with them.
There you go. Come on.
There you go. You know. How when we say we love God, and yet we hate our brother?
Yes.
Bye.
You know, that one always creeps up on a dummy.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I just... You're fine, but I just don't want to be with you. I just want to be around you. And those are the ones that God sent you to.
Yeah.
All that the Father shall give to you shall come to you, and you will in no wise cast out.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, that's a good one. That kicks, don't it?
I'm going to have to drink.
We have a second scripture to back that up.
Oh, yeah.
We don't have nothing to throw that one out. Amen? It might be an attack of killing the person spiritually, emotionally, or even physically. And the first thing that we must do to remove the strong hand of death and hell is to examine our fears, our hearts, and to be sure there's no bitterness in our lives. If there is any areas of unforgiveness, resentment, desires to retaliate, anger, hatred, violence, or a desire through thoughts, words, deeds, or murder, we have bitterness. Any memory or thoughts that bring pain is a symptom of bitterness. When we are willing to admit that we have bitterness, then we're down the road to recovery, to freedom. The next thing we must do is to repent. Oh, that's a goodie.
Yeah.
Repentance means turning away from our attitudes, feelings, agreement with the bitterness and ask God to forgive us. Then we must forgive others, ourselves, and we must realize that bitterness puts us into bondage to those whom we are bitter towards. God commands us to forgive without condition, without a timetable. Forgiveness is, I ain't over it.
Uh-huh.
What's your problem?
Uh-huh.
I ain't over it. Okay? And what's this? You like snake. You talking, still talking. You know who it is that got that from the world, brought it in the church. Ooh, goodness me. Snake. Medusa. Forgiveness is a moment by moment that's funny. A moment by moment occurrence for others and us. It is not dependent on how we feel. It's dependent on obedience to God. Because God commands, which frees us to live a life where death and hell and destruction cannot enter. The devil is riding our back.
Yes.
Get off of my back. I'm not a boat. That's all you have to say.
No.
Amen?
Amen?
It's good stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. I want you to stand up and listen to the prayer. I want you to grieve. I want you to come to the altar with me as we pray.
Yes.
Come on. Anybody wants to come to the altar with me? Hallelujah, Jesus. Come, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, folks. Act like nothing's wrong with us. Come on. When we were in the day of Moses, boy, everybody came to the altar. I just command a whole lot of us to come.
Yes.
You know there's some things that are inside of us need to come out. Just come. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay. Come. It feels good. It feels good. Draw yourself close unto God.
Yes.
Come on. Please. Please.
Yes.
Please.
Yes.
Please, come out of your seats.
Thank you.
Bow your heads. Leave without getting what you came for. Don't leave without getting what you came for. God loves you so much. I'm getting all my prayers ready. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, we resist and we break all curses and hexes and spells and incantations and voodoo and Santeria Palo Mayangi prayers. Or Kashiba, witchcraft, and especially the witchcraft related to the goddess of Diana. Masonic rituals, Egyptian occult worship and witchcraft, and African witchcraft and Caribbean witchcraft. We resist and break in Jesus' name all the influence of Eastern philosophies and religions and Hindu gods and Muslim worship. In Jesus' name, we resist and break all curses and hexes and spells and ceremonies and incantations off of this land used in the worship of false gods, including sexual and blood ritual sacrifices and covenants of all of these and any other worship of any of these kinds. In Jesus' name, we resist and break all charismatic, witchcraft, soulish prayers, fleshly prayers, assignments of the enemy through and in the body of Christ. We cancel all assignments through generational bloodiness as well as upon our family, and we apply the blood of Christ to break all strongholds and iniquity and rebellion in our family and in us, Lord. We confess our sins, any involvement with accusing spirits, accusing and judging others, accusing God, accusing ourselves, and we bring them to the cross of Calvary. We ask for forgiveness, Lord, from all the bitterness and unloving spirits and the jealousy and envy and rejection and rejected as idolatry and fear and occultism and pharmakia and sorcery cloaked under the disguise of religion. We raise up the sword of the Spirit, Lord, and we cut off all of these and any other godly bondage and ungodly character that we have, God. We break all soul ties to those related to those sins, and we claim the full protection as sons and daughters and as heirs of the Lord, of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and the shed blood of Jesus over all of us individually, our marriages, our family, our possessions, and our church body. We thank you that you have a shield about us, God. And you say to Satan on our behalf, the Lord rebuke you, Satan, you're a liar. The Lord has chosen Jerusalem. He's chosen his people, rebukes you in all these lives and situations and areas that we have just lifted up to the Lord. And in God's name, the Lord Jesus Christ, finally invite the Holy Spirit. Come renew fresh rain, fresh rivers of living water, and fill us up to this journey of this time. Father, we thank you, and you have raised us up with Christ, and you've seated us with the Lord Jesus in the heavens. And God, by agreeing with you in the name of Jesus, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bind up all the strong men of all the spirits of the elements and the rulers and the authorities and the powers of the dark world and the spiritual forces of evil and the heavenly realms on earth and under the earth. We choose to forgive our enemies, those that have sinned against us. We bless those that curse us. We bless those of opposition that they do not, because they don't know what they're doing, and the gods of this world have blinded them. And we thank you that you will guide us in all truth, God. And we pray that you will lead us into the knowledge of truth, God, and protect our families during this time of prayer, Father. We humble ourselves before you, Lord, and we present you ourselves and our family and our church body during this time of prayer through the power of the word, the cross, the resurrection of Jesus Christ, through the mighty name of Jesus that is the heir to that morning. And we bind the power of Satan, all his kingdoms, God, to speak against you in our lives, in our family, in our church family. We pray aside, and by the name of Jesus Christ, we bind up all Satan by Satan and his demons that have spoken against us. All of that shit coming on. We make a declaration that they have been destroyed in the name of Jesus. We proclaim through the blood of Christ on Calvary all assignments, schemes, and activity of Satan and his feet are broken. We bind up Satan's forces from having our family or possessions in honor and our inheritance, God. And we stand on Psalm 91 and ask that you dispatch your presence and your mighty angels to drive the enemy from our family, our church, and our homes. In Jesus' mighty name. Oh God, we thank you, Lord. Oh, 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 we thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you,
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, worship the Lord. 20 seconds, 20 seconds. Come on, worship the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. 15 more seconds. 15. Just 15 more seconds. Come on. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Keep that worship. And regenerates. Come on, give him a hand clap. Come on, give him a hand clap. Maybe 5 more minutes. Just sit with us. And you know, the best part of the service is the ending of the service. And we're almost there. We're going to ask that you would just be patient with us. It is offering time.
Yes.
Here at Crossroads Outreach Ministries. And we're going to ask to come Ms. Audrey Holly and Mr. Mike Provost. Hallelujah. Wasn't that good tonight?
Yes.
Amen. Amen. When Audrey and Mike come up, turn to Audrey and Mike. Now we want you to be a blessing tonight. A lot of people left. So we're going to believe God that God will touch you to do what only God can touch you to do. Hallelujah. Where's Audrey and Mike? Come on, stand here. Get your offering out right now. Get the biggest offering you have right now. Come on. Come on, sing that song. Come on, get the biggest offering you can. Amen. We're going to stand and we want to be a blessing here tonight. We're going to bless the Lord our God. I'm going to start this offering with $50. You do what the Lord puts on your heart to do. I'm going to start with 50 because to bring this kind of ministry to you and for churches to go out and do conferences, let me tell you, it takes a lot of planning, a lot of preparation, and it takes a lot of sacrifice.
Right.
And a lot of times in this region of the country, a lot of times want to minister and we want to bring quality to you. And yet sometimes we know that challenges come, but we kind of say, well, we'll give that dollar offering, and that's not enough. We ask you to give by faith. We ask you to give expecting God to honor you. We ask you to give what you are able to give, but we ask you to give cheerfully, because it is there where you will receive that return on your giving. And tonight we want you to give big. Big. Big for you may be whatever you deem big, but give big. Show God tonight. God, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for a time in the Spirit tonight.
Yes, God.
Come on, get it in your hands. I'm not collecting you. Who's collecting y'all?
Thank you, Lord. Right
now. All right, come on.
Amen.
God bless you.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, lift them up right now. Come on, lift them up.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God. Come now, come. Come now. Come on, come expecting God to do something for you. The Bible says, what you sow, you shall reap. And God doesn't just give us back what we give, He gives it back to us manifold, hundredfold. Come on, come with joy, come with thanksgiving, come with liberality, come with expectation. Don't let me do it. I'm just thanking God, hallelujah. Oh, bless His name, and we have. Praise and worship solo coming. back into the hands of our pastor for the hour, Pastor Sue Harrison. Come on, we don't want to miss anybody. Is there anyone else you have an offering that you want to give? Hallelujah. If the Lord has spoken to you and told you a little more, if he says, give a little bit more, just obey God, because God will, he will bless you. Oh, hallelujah. And especially if you have need. I like what the evangelist said. She said, in her deepest need, she kept paying her tithes and giving her offerings. We give them with joy and expectation. And God came through, and God will always come through. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. And we thank you all for being those. Did we miss anybody? We don't want to miss anybody. Hallelujah. Come on, stand to your feet, Lord. Stand to your feet, all over the sanctuary. Stand to your feet right now. Oh, hallelujah. Give me that blood circulating in your hand. Boy, we have time in the presence of God tonight. Amen. Let everybody give what they want to give. Amen. Would you stretch your hands of faith this way? Stretch your hands of faith this way. Hallelujah. We're going to pray. Thank you, Lord. Just one second. Father, in the name of Jesus, we praise, worship, and magnify your holy and majestic name. Thank you, O God, for everyone that gave tonight. Thank you, O God, even as we give in faith. We are in support, O God, of what you're doing in this ministry, in this region of the country. We glorify you right now that even on this night, a shockwave of your glory has moved from this place throughout the world for every woman of God in the world. O God, as those that have given tonight, as they have given by faith, come back to them, press down, shake them together, and run over. And oh God, we decree the budget met in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. And amen. Give the Lord a hand. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be his name. Blessed be his name. And as the evangelist makes her way, glory to God. Put your hands together as she goes. God bless you. Amen. Pastor Sue, come on up here. Give a lot of big hand clap for this visionary.
We're trying to get a location, so let's go with them. You can come out and support.
man of God right here. He's not going to receive this, but he's in big places. He does not have to be in this place here with us, trying to bring the gospel to the undying, the rejected, dejected, abandoned people. As soon as I called him, he said, well, what do you need me to do? I said, if you can just pray, whatever. He said, what do you want me to do? I said, MC. He said, you got it. Just like that. Just like that. Same thing like Reverend Bruce. I thank God for the men that he sends to help this Deborah, this JL, our ministry here. I receive it. I thank God for it. I do not take it lightly. Because this work is serious work. Praise the Lord. So thank you very much, men of God. Thank you.
We pray for y'all tomorrow night. Get some friends and bring them out tomorrow night. And we gonna party tomorrow night. We are. But let me tell you differently. You leave my bride. You can't leave without getting an offering. We got to open the door and stop you. You don't play around with me. We'll put you in the back door. So you wanna leave tomorrow night? Tell them to go to the I got some brothers in the back door waiting for you to ask me. Let's pray. God, we love you, praise you, thank you, God, give you glory for who you are, God. Praise you, Lord God, for the message, Father. I praise you, Lord God, because I believe in your existence, the spirit of deliverance, Father. I believe it. I believe, God, that the word tonight goes to the reaction may not have been with some thought, but I pray, God, that all upon good ground and broken, I know a seed was planted, Lord God, to encourage someone tonight, Father. Pray, Lord God, and we pray, be mine and me right now. I praise you, God, for Pastor Percy, Father, and for the Spirit Jesus. I pray, Father, for who she is. I praise you, Lord God, for Apostle Bill and Apostle Hayes. I praise you, God, that these great men don't be a smaller come and bless this house, God. Now, God, we're leaving, God. We're not leaving your presence, God. You are a Jehovah Shammah. You are ever present, God. So we pray, Lord God, give us travel mercy, Father. Take us safely, God, to our point of destination, God. Bring healing to the body right now, God. Bring deliverance, Father. And I pray even in this situation, God, bring praise. Your praise, your glory, because you're worthy, because you're worthy. We thank you, God, we say in Jesus' name, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And amen.
All right.